Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Dr. Ria, and if you are a final year student, then you are probably very emotionally traumatized by the NBE and you're probably confused about how to proceed with your studies now that INECET has been deferred. Well, in this video, I'm going to tell you exactly how you should study in this final year so that not only do you ace your university exams but also helps you crack NEET PG or NEXT. Okay, so the first thing I want to focus on is that now you can stop panicking and trying to complete all 19 subjects, right? Because you are only going to be giving your final year exams this year. So you have to really strengthen and focus on your final year subjects itself. That is medicine, surgery, obs gyne and pediatrics. And along with these, I want you guys to strengthen your ortho, psychiatry and dermat. Specifically these three minor subjects, because not only are they important for NEET PG and NEXT, but also they do have a weightage in your university exams as well. Especially orthopedics is asked quite a lot. So these are the seven subjects I want you guys to really master this year, and I think that's going to be possible because a lot of you guys would have already started preparing quite early because you were afraid of NEXT, and so many of you guys must have already gotten a head start. But if you had read these subjects superficially, now is the time to go back and strengthen those concepts, right? Because it's better late than never. And this mehnat you do right now, this effort you put in now, is going to help you next year when you're preparing for your NEET PG or next whichever exam it's going to be. You have to read these subjects in depth because you're not going to get the chance to read subjects like medicine and surgery especially in depth again, especially for your competitive exams. Whatever you read now, that is going to form the foundation and basis of all your 19 subjects, and that's going to be the most that you will read. You know, we don't get more than 10 days to study these subjects when we are preparing for NEET PG example, right? But now you guys have like so many months to study only this subject. So make sure you do it now in depth and don't brush over it superficially, because this will form a foundation and this will really help you integrate all the other concepts of the 19 subjects as well. So if you strengthen your clinical subjects now, if you are going to appear for NEET PG or INICET, we know that these subjects are important for those exams and it will save you time and you can focus on reading your first and second prof subjects then. But if you will be appearing for NEXT, then we already know that NEXT is more heavily based on your clinical subjects. So it's going to help you either way, whichever exam you're focusing on, to make sure that you strengthen your final year subjects now itself this year. Now about what to study exactly, I know that many of you guys are trying to juggle watching videos, making notes and reading textbooks, and I want to say one thing now, that do not eliminate textbooks from your preparation entirely. Textbooks are very important to build your concepts, right? You cannot just, I think you should not just rely on watching videos and making notes and just giving the exam. Because you are in final year, at least you should read the important topics from your textbooks. I know it's not possible to read the entire textbook end to end, but do read at least the important topics. For example, if you have watched a video and you have made your notes, do refer that topic from your textbook, because textbooks do offer a more detailed explanation and they do have images. So that will really help you integrate and try to understand that topic more intricately, and that will make that topic more long-lasting in your memory. And about which textbooks you should refer to, so just like I talk about the coaching apps, I'm gonna say the same thing about textbooks. Guys, just follow whichever textbook you like, which you are able to understand the language of. I know not all textbooks are very easy to understand. If you don't like it, don't follow it, no matter what somebody else says. But if you want to know which textbooks I read, I will tell you that. I read Davidson for medicine, SRB for surgery, Amdatta for obs and Shaw for gyne, and of course Ghai for peds. And I read Maheshwari for orthopedics, and for the other minor subjects I just read my notes, because I don't think you have to read your textbooks for the minor subjects, but you can refer them of course if you need to. And when it comes to making notes, many of you guys might be struggling to finish watching all the video lectures of the subjects as well, because I know those lectures are also very extensive. So in that case, don't stress yourself. I will say try to put in as many hours as you can to finish that, to finish all the videos. But in case you are not able to, don't stress, at least watch the videos of the important topics. Okay, and important topics can be found from both your previous set questions of your university exams. Okay, just like we solve the PYQs of NEET PG or INICET, I want you guys to go back and see all the previously asked questions from your university. And as we know, even in the university exam, tends to be quite predictable. They do repeat the commonly asked topics. So there are going to be a bulk of, like, you know, a bank of important topics. And I want you guys to mark all of those topics in your textbooks, not in your notes. I feel your notes should be reserved for your competitive competitive exams. I do want you guys to refer your notes and read your notes for better understanding, but don't start marking all your university exam questions in your notes, because later on when you will be marking your PYQs from your NEET PG or next exam, then it will get very, very messy because you will have marked all these different exams in the same notes. So I will say mark all of your college exam questions in your textbooks. Open your textbooks and mark those topics which have been frequently asked before, and focus on those topics more and watch the videos of those topics first, right? If you have a crunch of time. So just like PYQs help us ace our competitive exams, the same PYQs of your college exams are going to help you ace your university exams as well. But I will say, at least now, you should try to read as many topics as you can, as thoroughly as you can, right? Don't try to read very selectively from now itself, because you have a while before your college exams, right? I would say try to be more selective in the last 2 months before your exam. Right now, you can try to have a more, you know, concept-based approach while studying, so that it helps you both for your college exams and NEET PG. Don't try to mug up all the facts. Don't try to mug up the long answers from now itself. Keep the mugging up for the last 2 months. Believe me, the last 2 months are going to be enough if you just focus completely on, you know, mugging all the topics. But for now, do try to read, understand, make notes of as many topics as you can, as thoroughly as you can. That would really, really, really help you build a strong foundation and a strong concept. But if you are in a crunch of time, then yes, you can start reading more selectively from now itself. About solving MCQs, I don't think that now that you don't have to give up an MCQ based exam this year itself, I don't think you guys have to stress too much about practicing MCQs. If you really want to, I would say start out by solving the previous year questions again, so that you know which topics that you should focus more on right now, which topics you should watch videos of and make notes of, and, you know, try to strengthen more. So you can solve the previous year questions, but apart from that, don't stress too much about your MCQ skills. You will have more time to strengthen them later. For now, just try to read that subject really nicely and sweetly. Try to understand your concepts, make your notes, refer your textbook, so that you don't have to waste time trying to build your concepts again when you are preparing for your competitive exams later on. And the last thing I want to talk to you guys about are your clinical postings. So please don't bunk your clinical postings to study. Those 1 to 2 hours which you study extra will not help you that much. But if you don't attend your postings, you will feel very, very underconfident in your final practicals when you have to take a case and present a case. And not only that, you're going to lack some very important skills which you do require to become a doctor. So please do, if you have a good patient load and you have good seniors there especially who are willing to teach you, please go to your wards, take cases, present the cases, discuss those cases with your friends. You know, take your manual along with you, like S-Task for surgery or Bulur for medicine or whichever book that you follow. Take it with you, reread it there itself in those 2 hours, so you don't have to waste time to read those manuals again when you come home, right? So please don't bunk your postings. If you do go there, you're gonna really be strong with your practical skills, and you'll be very confident when you have to present those cases again in your final year. So I hope this video helped calm your nerves and give you more confidence about how to study in your final year. And if you still have any doubts, please feel free to ask me in the comments, or you can also join my Telegram group and ask me there as well. So until we meet next time, keep studying, and let's meet soon. Bye.